Hey guys, Sean at Berg Performance here. Behind me I have a 2017 Macan GTS that has a 3-liter twin turbo V6 power plant in it. This car has come in here for a front timing cover reseal is the big portion of this job that we're going to be knocking out. Valve covers is also going to be part of that. Valve covers do need to be removed in order to gain enough access to remove the front timing cover from the engine. But in order to get that deep, the engine does need to be removed from the car. Easiest way to do that on this chassis is to lower the subframe with the engine transmission and the lower half of the front suspension along with it. So the whole powertrain will come down as one unit. So that's going to be the big part of the job that we're knocking out on this one. It also has some front suspension repairs that we're going to be doing. There's 8 bushings at minimum, I guess, technically 12 bushings in the front suspension of this car, but 6 of the 8 primary bushings in the front suspension of this car have also failed. Not an uncommon failure for an air suspension Macan to see some worn out bushings at around 55,000 miles. So we're going to go ahead and get those bushings replaced. We're going to get the front timing cover oil leak repaired and resealed, as well as valve covers resealed along with that. It's going to get a new serpentine belt when we're in there, kind of all the preventative maintenance items, all the idler pulleys for the serpentine belt system, stuff like that. Anything that is worth doing while the engine's out of the car, that's a lot easier to do while the engine's out of the car, we're going to go ahead and knock out. So that's the shakedown on this car, and we're about to get rolling.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
We are finishing up this Macan GTS front timing cover reseal and front suspension repair job. Car's on the alignment rack right now, getting ready to be aligned. Kind of the last thing we need to do before the car gets some miles put on it to verify the repair is all good, and then it goes back to the customer. A couple of hiccups that we had on this job was as the engine came down, AC compressor needed to be removed from the engine because we didn't have a special tool to disconnect an AC line from the body of the car underneath the driver's side of the windshield. So that one was a little interesting. I needed a couple extra hands as the powertrain was coming down to kind of guide that line out of the way of the engine coming down. So that was a little interesting. Thankfully, we were able to get that tool during reassembly so I could remove that line, the AC line from the body, reinstall the AC compressor with the engine out of the car, which is a lot nicer, get that AC line routed and installed. So when the engine and powertrain went back into the car, it went in real easy, pretty much a straight shot on the way up, which was great. We did find some broken bolts during the disassembly of this one, which is not uncommon for this. Porsche likes to use some really lightweight aluminum bolts for the valve covers, as well as the front timing cover on this engine, due to heat cycles and a number of other reasons that are pretty complicated and complex to describe. Those bolts break occasionally, and you'll lose tension on the sealing surface of whatever surface that bolt is holding together, causing a leak of some sort, usually oil in this case. We did have a leak from a broken bolt on the valve cover, and then we did have one from the timing cover as well. Was able to extract both of those bolts pretty painlessly, which is good. Car went together with pretty much no hiccups, thankfully, because we had all the tooling and stuff that we needed to get the car assembled correctly the first time. And yeah, everything went together nice and easy. Front suspension repairs were pretty run-of-the-mill. Nothing crazy to report there. Car's on the alignment rack getting ready to be aligned. Have some miles put on it. Make sure nothing's leaking. Then we can deliver it back to the customer.